Bismillah, alhamdulillah, salatu wassalamu ala rasulullah, ma ba'd. Welcome everybody to a short and brief tutorial about the HID keyboard attack. The HID keyword, or the HID abbreviation, stands for Human Interface Device. And this little attack actually has been recently discovered, where a smartphone or a USB stick can easily act as a HID, a Human Interface Device, like a keyboard, a mouse, or whatsoever. So in this little tutorial, I'm gonna show you how my smartphone, and my smartphone is OnePlus One, how my smartphone actually, I'm gonna show you how my smartphone can easily act as a keyboard. So for example, if I can actually go ahead and plug my smartphone into your computer, actually I can instruct my smartphone to execute a couple of commands on your computer, and you know, for example, invoking a malicious backdoor that I've already published on the internet, so I can actually compromise your computer without your knowledge. Okay, so for example, I can enable the remote desktop protocol, I can create new accounts, I can delete files, copy files, send them by emails. There's a couple of scenarios there that can be realized. Okay, so let's actually go ahead and let me show you how this little action can easily be done. So I've created a couple of scripts here. So the first one I'm gonna show you is the reverse shell, and as you can see here, this little scripting actually is understood by the NetHunter, and the Kali NetHunter is a new operating system based on Android that you can install on your smartphone. But supported for the time being, the supported devices are actually OnePlus and Google Nexus. Okay, so you can actually grab a OnePlus One or OnePlus Two smartphone and install NetHunter on it. Okay, so for example, when the NetHunter actually sees this little script, this, for example, the GUI R, it would actually invoke the key, the button, the window button plus R located on my keyboard. For example, if I hold them both, hold those both, for example, as you can see here, this little window would pop up. It would delay for, as you can see here, 750 milliseconds, and it would pass in the keyword CMD. It would hit enter, and it would actually hold the button Alt plus space and go down one time and hit enter to move it left in order to hide this little window from the user. Okay, just to hide this little window, so the user is unaware of what's going on his or her computer. And once this little actions are happened, as you will see here, I will actually use PowerShell to act as a web client, download the file, download the backdoor, which is located on my Kali Linux machine. As you can see here, var www.html backdoor.exe, this is my file. And Apache is running, status, Apache is running, exactly. And actually, I can download it and immediately start it as a process, okay? But I'm going to start backdoor.exe, okay? I've already saved the file. I can actually copy it. And I'm going to plug my phone, my friends. So I'm gonna plug it up. And my phone is being plugged, and as you can see here, just I'm gonna paste that script and replace it by the old one. Okay, so here, before doing so, I'm going to use exploits multi-handler, and I'm gonna set my payload to Windows meter preter reverse TCP. Okay, and I'm gonna set, let me first show all hosts, show options, and I'm gonna set my L port to 4545, I'm going to set my L host to this little IP, which is my IP address, okay? This the Kali Linux IP address. Now I can run the exploit and background it. So as you can see here, the exploit has been run successfully. And let me invoke this script. As you will see momentarily, my phone would act exactly as a keyboard, pop up that little window, CMD, hide it, and execute, download the backdoor and execute it. So launch the attack, and ta-da! So you would hide it, boom, download it, and execute the backdoor. And indeed, a meterpreter session has been opened. If we do session-l, session-i, interact with session number one, I can execute remotely a couple of commands like the ps, which lists the available or the running processes. I can even get a shell. And sys, for example, I can do ipconfig, hostname, whatever you want, okay? So CCNFIFA available. As you can see here, this is Windows 7, x64-bit work group, so on and so forth. So this is the first scenario. Let me show you another scenario. So for example, here I've got an RDP. I'll do the telecom. So this little script actually would run a PowerShell script. As you can see here, it would actually drop the menu bar here and pass in this little PowerShell command. So after hitting enter, it would actually bypass what we call the UAC, the user access control, okay, the UAC. It would click on yes, and as you can see here, the working directory is system32, which means this is a privileged user. I can execute whatever I want, okay? That's what this little stuff do here, and it would create a user and enable the RDP and start the service. So let me actually string, okay? Okay, let's actually come back to the RDP script here, and I'm going to pass in here as a string, save it, copy it, paste it on the download folder, replace it by the old one, and let's check if the RDP is enabled. Okay, let's go to my right click on my computer, go to properties, advanced system parameters, remote control, and as you can see, it's disabled. And if we kind of go ahead and go to right click on my computer, go to manage, and try to go to users and groups, users, there is no such user. There is no AT user. So let's minimize these little windows and just, I am going to, let's actually close this little machine, power off, I don't need it anymore. And let's actually grab that script. Okay, so I'm holding my phone. I'm gonna load the RDP script. I'm gonna launch the attack. So 1, 2, 3, and boom. Okay, that's great. It would click yes, and a privileged cmd.exe has been ran. The commands has been executed, or the commands have been executed, and indeed, if we kind of go ahead and refresh this page, a little user has been created here. And if we kind of go ahead and go to advanced system parameters, remote controls, indeed, the RDP has been enabled. So I'm gonna disable it for security reasons. And I am going, my friends, to delete this little user because it's a hacker stuff. It's pretty dangerous. It's not safe at all. So hopefully you like NetHunter, and hopefully you like my little scripts. So if you like it, go ahead and purchase OnePlus One, install NetHunter, and play around. So I'd like to thank you for viewing this video, my friends. See you next time.